admit for the first time what it says in Ephesians, that our battle, your struggle, my struggle, it's not against flesh and blood, is what the Bible says. In other words, it's not against another human. It's a spirit. There is a real enemy. His name is Satan, the devil, and he's not nice. His goal is to come, and he does attack us. He does lie to us. He does tempt us. He does try to discourage us. He does cause things to happen. He's not more powerful than God. He has that much power, but he tries to use that much power. And my goal for this series, and my hope for you tonight, if the light bulb hasn't gone off yet, is for you to understand that you're in a battle, a spiritual one. That life isn't just having fun and hanging out with friends and going through school. No, there is a spiritual battle. You are a spiritual person. When your life on earth ends, which is really a short window, 80 years, maybe, somewhere in there, when your time on earth ends, spiritual life continues forever. So we better get it right. There is literally eternal consequences to the way that we live life here on this earth. So wake up. And some of you are going through struggles right now. This week has been the worst week of your life. You're going through struggles right now, and you're looking at it from a human standpoint. And I don't want you to look at it from a human standpoint. You got to look at it from a spiritual standpoint. Our battle is not against flesh and blood. There is no other name but the name of Jesus. Did you hear the words of that song? It's catchy. You can sing it. It's powerful. There's some Bible in that song. Chains will break in the name of Jesus. You can say amen to that.
Amen.
Freedom comes whenever we call on the name of Jesus. You can say amen to that.
Amen.
There is healing, physical healing, that comes whenever we call out to Jesus. There's emotional healing, guys. Some of you, you're just like in this circle of just tears everywhere. There's emotional healing that comes not when you go see a shrink or another human or something. It comes whenever you call on the name of Jesus. Why? Because it's spiritual. And I just felt led during that song for us to pause before we move on with service. And I want you to close your eyes. Not that closing your eyes is more spiritual, it's just less distracting whenever you can focus on God. So whatever you got to do to focus, I want you to do that. If it's closing your eyes, close them. But here's what you got to understand. You're a spiritual person. If you're in this room tonight and you have been living life without the understanding that you're a spiritual person, I want you to just have a moment between you and God tonight and say, God, I recognize I need you. I call on you, Jesus. Forgive me my sins. Guide me in my life. I'm not the boss of my life. I need you. I need God to be God. So right now, if that's you, if you've never given your life to God, I want you to do that right now. Just say, God, my life is yours. I don't fully understand that. I got to grow and I got to learn, but it starts with saying, God, I need you. I call out to the name of Jesus. I got chains. I got hurts. I got sin. I got garbage. I just need Jesus. So in your own words, English, Spanish, French, I don't care. But call out to him and just say, God, I need you. I give my life to you, the good, the bad, the ugly, my future dreams, my present reality, everything. I just give it to you right now. Surrender your life to God right now. It's the best decision I'll ever make. Others of you, you know the deal. You're a Christian. You prayed that prayer a long time ago, but you've just been kind of like dumb recently. And you've kind of been complaining about life. And you've honestly just been spiritually apathetic a little bit. It's time to wake up. It's time to wake up for you to understand that you're in a battle. There's a very real enemy. His name is Satan. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy, John says. Steal, kill, and destroy. Those aren't nice things. So you have to face him with the weapons of God. You got to face him with prayer. You got to face him with scripture. And so right now, you can feel it. You're under attack, and I want you to wake up, and I want you to fight back in prayer. Last week, we'll look at it again tonight, but last week we talked about James 4:7. Submit yourself to God. Resist the devil in prayer, and he will flee from you. Some of you, do that right now. Begin to pray right now. Satan, you come after me this week, but no, I win in the name of Jesus. There's freedom in the name of Jesus. I don't have to be in bondage anymore in the name of Jesus. This family thing that's going on in my house, I just declare freedom in the name of Jesus. Some of you, you're not healthy. Your family member isn't healthy. There's a very real sickness. I don't know if Caitlin's here tonight, but there's just this real sickness in your body. In the name of Jesus, be healed. There is no other name. It's not just physical, it's spiritual. In the name of Jesus, be healed. God, I just pray from the top to the bottom of this room for every person that's here that we would understand the power that we have in the name of Jesus. And that we would live in that power. you're a senior, we have something special prepared for you right now, so I want you to go ahead and leave and go up to the loft. David and Priscilla will be there for you. Everybody else say hey and have a seat.
Good.
Oh, that's cool.